Welcome to the final episode of the Beginner's Guide. If you followed along, you have a self-sufficient base, unlimited components, and a thriving farm. But we are missing the final, most crucial resources, uranium and platinum, which are most reliably found in space. Today, we build the ultimate transitional ship designed to safely lift off this planet and begin your journey through the stars. First, preparation. We need a stable building area. We'll build a conveyor line out from our base about 18 blocks with a connector pointing upwards. Weld everything up, as this is going to be where we build the ship from, and we need to be able to put ice, hydrogen, oxygen, and cargo in it. From there, we drop an inset connector facing down. Go to the connector in the control panel and lock it to the base connector. This will ensure that while we build the ship, everything gets filled and it has power. We are building a highly efficient hydrogen atmospheric hybrid. We start with the core life support and power blocks. From the connector, place an O2H2 generator on top with its side ports facing forwards and backwards. We'll add another O2H2 generator heading back with its side ports now facing left-right for thrusters eventually. On the end of that O2H2 generator, we attach a large hydrogen tank. On the end of that tank, a conveyor junction. And on the end of that, a large hydrogen thruster. This will be our main forward thrust, which can be used to leave the planet or get you away from harm in space very quickly. Now heading back to the front of the ship, we go back to that first O2H2 generator and add a conveyor junction. On the left and right side of that conveyor junction, add O2H2 generators with their side ports facing left-right. On each outside of the last O2H2 generators we added, add an elbow conveyor, then a small cargo container on the end of that. Next to the small cargo containers, we add a battery on both sides of the ship, creating a mirrored design. On the inside of the cargo containers, on the end of the O2H2 generators, we add four armored T conveyors pointing down, which will be for our lifting upward thrust, with a conveyor junction at the end. Moving back up to the front most O2H2 generators we placed, we attach a gyroscope to the side of each one. This will be a bit of excessive turning from the gyroscopes, but it's always good to add more and tune their power down to the current weight/load of your ship. From the center line, where the conveyor junction is, we add an oxygen tank, then a refill station. After that, a survival kit, all ending with a small cargo container. At the last two O2H2 generators we placed, we cap them off with full air vents on either side of the ship. This will be how we pressurize our interior. Now, with the core blocks placed, we can start adding the thrusters. Let's start at the rear. On either side of the large forward hydrogen thruster, we add armored corner conveyors pointing backwards and attach small hydrogen thrusters to each of them. These will be our primary forward thrusters when we get to space. We'll be able to shut off the large one to conserve hydrogen fuel. From there, we move on to the conveyor junction attached to the large hydrogen thruster and place a small hydrogen thruster in every direction, left, right, up, down. Next, on either side of the hydrogen tank, we put a small hydrogen thruster. We move on to the conveyor junction's two blocks in front and add left-right hydrogen thrusters there too. This gives us three left and three right hydrogen thrusters, which allows for great maneuvering. Next, on top of the first O2H2 generator we placed attached to the connector, we add a small hydrogen thruster. Then we add to the bottom of the ship, and using those T conveyors we placed, we add six small hydrogen thrusters to finish out our hydrogen lifting thrust, giving us seven, which should allow us to safely land on most planets. The last hydrogen thruster we need to place is our braking thruster. On the small cargo container at the front, we add an armored straight conveyor down, a small cargo container, and then two armored corner conveyors facing forward with drills on the end. Between the drills, we place our last small hydrogen thruster. To give us some boost in gravity, we add two flat atmospheric thrusters, one block in front of the most forward small hydrogen side thruster we added, attached to the small cargo and battery. We now have a functional ship. The only thing stopping you from flying this is a control seat, so let's add that. Head to the straight armored conveyor all the way at the front. Let's add two armor blocks forward, and on that forwardmost one, let's put a control seat. For utility, I go to the back and on the right side corner conveyor for our forward thrust, I put an ore detector, so we can find the ore we need in the asteroids in space. On the opposite side, the left, I add an action relay. Could come in handy as these allow you to remotely send signals to grids, and on the end of that, an antenna. From here, the only thing left is armoring and design. All of this can be done how you want, but I'll show you how I designed my ship. I gave a nice curved glass bridge to the front, allowed for a soft airlock near the base of the ship so you can enter when landed. Added spotlights on the outside in front of the flat atmospherics for great forward visibility, and corner lights inside for interior lighting. Used armor paneling for little catwalks inside, and designed the exterior with some armoring to make it look good and add a bit of protection to some of the blocks. Though the ship is mainly for exploring space, not meant to really dive into combat. Speaking of combat, the last piece to all of this is a Gatling turret, added on top of the hydrogen tank, allowing you a way to defend yourself. We now have our spaceship, allowing us to finally take off from this planet when our hydrogen tanks, oxygen tank, and batteries are full charge, and start exploring space. Don't forget to bring some food. To conserve the most fuel, it's best to add thrust overrides to your bar. I like to have three spots just for taking off from gravity on all my ships. A spot for removing all thrust overrides, decreasing and increasing. Depending how you plan to take off, those are the thrusters you need to have a part of this thrust override group. Just keep in mind that if you have random encounters on, and global encounters, space can be a bit dangerous. There are multiple types of factions, all with their different types of threats. I have a great video that goes over all these different factions that I'll link to this video. Your main goal once you reach space is to search asteroids for uranium and platinum. While you can find these in some planetary encounters, space is the most reliable way to acquire them. Uranium is fantastic for powering reactors, which will solve a lot of your power problems. Platinum is used for crafting high-tech blocks like ion thrusters, which are mainly designed for space and just require power like atmospheric thrusters to work. Once you work your way through the space encounter factions, acquiring all components you could ever dream of, you'll realize you've started finding a lot of Prototech components. This brings us to the endgame. That unidentified signal that has always been looming in the distance is some of the hardest NPC content you can find, but all with the reward of them having Prototech blocks. These blocks are great to capture and can't be built like normal blocks. They have components in them that grind a special Prototech scrap, and you can either go out to all these encounters and capture each block on its own, or gather enough Prototech frames and components and a Prototech assembler and start creating your own blocks. I hope you've enjoyed this series, and I look forward to hearing all about your adventures in Space Engineers on our Discord. For more helpful information, check out the official Space Engineers wiki. Shout out to the crazy optical VIX YouTube member, The Mightiest Kaz. Thank you for your amazing support. As always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and subscribe for more. I'll see you in the next video.